Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Stable Diffusion for Professional Creatives. Today, we'll take a look at a bit of an update to my Photoshop to ComfyUI workflow. This is going to be a very short video, but one I think that it's needed in order to update a video that has been receiving quite a bit of an attention. It's not really an update, but since, well, an update happened to the node, and a lot of you have asked, how do I use that node in the way you used it in your previous video? Well, I thought I could create a new video updated for the latest changes. And also, let's face it, that was my second or third video ever, so I wasn't the great YouTuber I am now, of course. This is the workflow that we are going to use today. Never mind a bit of a workflow on the right, that's entirely optional and bypassed for now. But the core of the workflow is very simple. Let me explain that to you. It's basically an image-to-image workflow that starts from an image inside of Photoshop that gets transferred to ComfyUI via this Photoshop to ComfyUI node. I will show you later how to install it. Then it gets scaled down to a suitable size in megapixel, in this case 1 megapixels, and gets encoded as a latent. Then we are also extracting depth and using that as a control net at a lowish strength, 0.4. And in order to get fast results out of this, we are using a lighting version of an SDXL model, in this case Juggernaut V9 SDXL Lightning. That allows us to use just 8 steps and gets results out fast. We are giving a bit of a prompt of what we want to see, in this case a fashion photography of a black young woman, because that's the base that I will use inside of Photoshop. Now let's go install this Photoshop to ComfyUI node that you won't be able to find inside of the manager. So the first thing that you need to know is that the node that we are going to use was a very good node that has been created by Nima. But since the time I released my previous videos that used this node, Nima has updated his node. And this was a major update. And the way the Photoshop nodes work now is much closer to a plugin than it is to a single node that connects to Photoshop. Luckily enough, what we can do, since this node was released on GitHub, is either check out via terminal command a previous version of this node, or what we could also do is look for our previous fork that has the kind of node that we want. For example, there's this fork here that is from 3 months ago, so before the node upgrade. If we go here, we will see that this node is the previous version of it. So in order to install the Photoshop to ComfyUI node, all we have to do is copy this link here. You will find the link to the GitHub in the description below. Go to our Comfy folder, locate the custom nodes, and then right click, open in terminal, and write down git clone and paste the link to the GitHub and hit enter. Now, of course, I'm going to get an error because I already have it installed, but if you do that, you will install it. This is the only node that needs to be installed this way. All the other nodes that we're going to use, you can install them via the manager by just dragging and dropping the workflow that you will find in the description below inside of your ComfyUI instance. So once you've done this, you just need to run Comfy like you normally would, and then import the workflow and install the missing custom nodes. Now, back inside of the workflow, what we need to do is just set up a password here for Photoshop connection. In my case, that's 1234 1234, and then we have to go back inside of Photoshop. Here in the Edit tab, we want to go to Remote Connections, enable Remote Connections, and set the same password, 1234 1234, in my case, that we used inside of the Photoshop to ComfyUI node. Click OK, and then the connection will be established. Now, back inside of Comfy, what we just need to do is enable the extra options here on the sidebar and hit Auto Queue, and then hit Queue Prompt. Now, we will see that we will be getting this image from Photoshop inside of ComfyUI, and we will see that we start getting a depth map, and the generation starts, and we get an image that is close to the one we have in Photoshop. This image is passed through all of the way to the back of the workflow to a preview pop-up node. What this does, if we go back to Photoshop, is bring up a pop-up here that allows us to see a preview of what's happening inside of Stable Diffusion. If we place it here with pin, we can then start working on our image. So let's say we want to add a layer and add a bit of a beret. We will see that we will get the same kind of hat based on the paintbrush we did right in the generation. Now, I've set the key sampler to fixed seed, so if we don't change anything, the resulting image won't change. If we look at the terminal, it takes around 13 seconds in order to get an image. So it's not too long that we have to wait for a new image. Let's add some earrings, for example. Let's do this over here. And here we go, we get the earrings right here. Now, of course, if we want to go faster, we could by disabling the control net, but then we would have less control on the final result. Like in this case, the depth is not controlled anymore. It is faster. It's shaving off a couple of seconds from the generation. Now it's doing that in 11 seconds, but I don't think that's a good enough time difference that I want to lose control for it. So we're going to enable it again. And speaking of control, I've also left you with an optional relight group. If you enable this, what will happen is the image, once it's generated, is going to get passed through the relighting group as well. That's going to add you 10 to 15 seconds, but it's going to give you a nicer result overall, as we can see here, for example. If we want to stop the generation, all we need to do is disable the auto queue and cancel the generation, and then it will stop. Now, of course, this is great for picture, this is great for drawing inside of Photoshop and then regenerating something. Like in this case, where I changed the positive prompt to landscape photo of a mountain range cinematic light, I upped the noise up to 0.9, and I lowered the depth to 0.2 in order to give it a bit more freedom. And I can keep adding details as much as I want and get more and more images out of it every 10 seconds or so. If I find like the denoise is a bit too high and I'm not getting precise enough results, I can always go back to ComfyUI and lower the denoise a bit. This workflow, for example, can be especially useful for quick comping. If you are using the relighting group and are adding a remove background node and an image blend by mask node, for example. Like in this case, where I just added a Roomba on top of some sand, I changed the positive prompt to advertising photo of a Roomba on a sand dune, added a remove background node, and blended the two resulting images together, one with the original subject and one with the regenerated subject, which we don't want, of course, but we want the background. The image gets then passed on to the relighting group, it gets relit, and then it gets color matched, and the details gets preserved. So thank you all for tuning in today for this very, very short tutorial and explanation. If you're interested in more product relighting and product photography in general, you can check out this previous video that I made. If you like this video, please leave a like and subscribe. I want to thank all of my supporters on Ko-fi. My name is Andrea Baioni. You can find me on Instagram at Rizunobushi or on the web at andreabaioni.com. And same as always, I will be seeing you next week.